Hello my dear students, welcome back to one more class. And in today's class we are going to study the topic thermodynamics. Thermodynamics, this is one of the important topic of class 11th as well as few concepts we are going to study in class 12th. Now let's understand what do you mean by thermodynamics. According to its name, thermo it means heat. The word thermo has been used for heat purposes, right? And dynamics, it means motion. Dynamic, it means motion. So the properties, the concepts related to the heat and its motion, it means the mechanical work which will done by those properties is considered as a thermodynamics. So before starting with the topic thermodynamics, let's try to understand few basic terms which we are going to often use while studying in thermodynamics chapter. Students, you may wonder that this thermodynamics chapter is there in class physics as well as in chemistry. So do not get confused. Whatever the concepts we are studying in chemistry, those all are related to the chemical thermodynamics. Thermodynamics, although many concepts are same, but there is a slight difference in few of the concepts as well, right? So thermodynamics is that here in class 11th which we are going to study is chemical thermodynamics. So before starting with the further topics of this chapter, let's understand few terminologies. And what are those? The first terminology which we are going to study in today's class are system, surroundings. What do you mean by system and surrounding? That I'll explain. Second topic is open, closed and isolated system, right? Next one is state of the system and variable. What do you mean by that? Then next is microscopic, macroscopic system and properties of that macroscopic system. So student, let's start with the first concept of this chapter, and that one is system and the surrounding. So first is system and the surrounding. So let's understand system. What do you mean by system? Student, see, as consider that this is a room and in this room I am doing any chemical reaction. Okay, so that particular area where the reactions are going on, that can be in the open one, that can be in the lab, that can be in the classroom, or that can be in the any of the room, or that can be on a small table. So the area on which chemical reactions are getting performed, all that area is considered as system. All that area is considered as system where the chemical processes occurring. Right? And the second concept is surrounding. Surrounding means what? Surrounding, it means the area other than the system. The area other than the system is considered as a surrounding. And do you know that the complete universe is made up of system and the surrounding? Okay, consider that here I am in the class and I am doing some reaction here on the table. So the reaction which is done on the table is considered as a system, and the area, the rest of all area of this room is considered as a surrounding. So system and the surrounding, you should know very basic concept is this, and I hope everybody understood about system and the surroundings. So student, system means what? The area, the part of the universe where the chemical reactions or chemical processes are occurring. So here I am writing its definition, that is system. System, it means it is a part of universe. It is a part of universe where, it is the part of universe where chemical processes occurs, and that one is known as system. Second one we will be studying, that one is surroundings. Now let's understand what do you mean by surroundings. Surrounding it means part of universe. I'll rather than writing a part of universe other than system. part of universe other than system is considered as surrounding. And as I already told, universe is made up of system and the surrounding. Now, students, see here, we have some types of systems. And what are those types of system that I'll be explaining? The first type of system is open system. The first one is open system, second one is closed system, and third one is isolated system. Now, let's understand one by one, what do you mean by open system, what do you mean by closed system, and what do you mean by isolated system. So, open system, it means if I am doing, consider that I am doing a reaction in a container. In the laboratory, we have many containers, so I took the beaker and I am doing reaction in that. Now, consider that students, there I am doing some reaction, and if any vapors will come out or any heat will released in that reaction, that may get exchange with the surrounding, that may get exchange with the surrounding, and such type of system is known as open system. That such type of system is known as open system. So open system is that system in which matter and heat get exchanged between the surroundings. Matter and heat get exchanged in surrounding. It means, I'll be giving you your day-to-day life examples also. Exchange between the surrounding, right? And such type of system is known as open system. Consider that I am doing a reaction, and that reaction, any chemical reaction, if I want to study the boiling point, right? Okay, boiling. So boiling, although we know that it's a physical process, but student, here you want to understand what is open system. So when I will be doing boiling of water, you know that how the matter can exchange with the surrounding. Matter will convert it into vapors, water will convert it into vapors, and that will get mixed with the air present there. So it means matter is getting, and secondly is heat. How heat can exchange with the surrounding? Heat can be exchanged with the surrounding. Like if I am kept that container there only, so after some time the temperature of that container will decrease. It means the temperature has been released in the surrounding. So such type of system is known as open system, where matter and heat both get exchanged with the surrounding, or both get mixed with the surrounding. Now, next one is closed system. So student, try to understand the closed system. What do you mean by it? Closed system is that system where matter do not get exchanged with the surrounding, only heat exchanged with the surrounding. It means I am doing that, if I am doing again the reaction, and in that reaction if I am doing some reaction in a closed container, so when I am doing that reaction in a closed container, so there is no possibility of getting matter exchanged with the surrounding. Am I correct? Okay, so in that situation we are saying that only the heat will get exchanged with the surrounding, and such type of system is known as closed system. Now let's understand about the isolated system. What do you mean by it? Isolated system is that system in which neither heat nor matter get exchanged with the surrounding. And here we can take an example. So it means we took in such an insulated container in which heat will also not exchange with the surrounding nor matter. Student, if I want to explain this in terms of day-to-day life example, so please keep in mind, day-to-day life example, how can we explain? Consider that I am having a If I am having a cup of tea, and that cup is made up of steel. So what will happen after some time? You can observe that after some time, the temperature of that tea which is there in the cup, that will get decreased. It means heat has been heat is exchanged with the surrounding. Similarly, some of the tea can convert it into vapors. It means matter is also surrounded, matter is also exchanged with the surrounding. Now, consider that the same cup of tea I am having, and that one is covered properly, it is having a lid properly, then what will happen? Matter cannot exchange with the surrounding, but heat can be exchanged with the surrounding. And third one, to understand the isolated system, we will say that yes, isolated system is that system where the matter and the heat will not exchange. It means we can take an example of thermos flask, any insulated flask. So if we are having this thermos flask, so in that thermos flask we cannot exchange, or that matter and heat both cannot exchange with the surrounding. And this is the reason that in any of the thermos flask, you can observe, students, see, I am having this flask, and in this flask you can observe that this flask, the water which I poured in that, the hot water will be remain hot. Neither the level of water will change nor the temperature. It means that such type of system is known as insulated or isolated system. Okay, so student, I hope you understood all the three types of system. Now let's understand the next one. And next one is state of system or state variables. State of system or state variables. Now, state of system or state variable, it means state variables. State variables or state of system. State of system, it means that whether the state of the, while performing any chemical reaction, what is the state of that particular system, whether it is in a solid form or it is in a liquid form, or after doing the reaction, what would be the state of that particular system, that here we can consider that. And student, always keep in mind, the state of has been considered as a before the reaction and after the reaction. Now you will say that, ma'am, before the reaction it is solid, after the reaction then also it is solid, then how to differentiate between the state of system? Simply we will say that state of system, it means initial state and the final state. State of system, how can we consider it as a state of system? State of system, it means initial state and final state. Initial state and final state, everybody knows about before, if any observations we are taking before the reaction or in the beginning of the reaction, that one is considered as initial state. And if any observations are there after the reaction, then that is considered as a final state of that reaction. Okay, of that system. Now, state variables means what? There are some properties which can express the initial state as well as final state. For example, if I am taking for example as a temperature. Okay, so in temperature we can say that yes, the initial temperature of that system would be this one, and after the reaction the final state of that system would be that one. So there are some properties which expresses the state of the system, like initial state, final state, and such properties are known as state variables. Such properties are known as state variables, right? One more concept here we need to study, and that one is state function. That one is state function. Now student, let's understand, what do you mean by state function? State function, it means state functions are those functions which depend upon, right? So we have two type of functions. First of all, we'll say that state function, and another one is path function. Both the way I'll explain. First of all, state function do not depend upon the path. Do not depend upon the path or the route. Do not depend upon the path or the route by which that system, that state has attained. So what do you mean by it? It means that the state function, it means consider that the temperature, the con- this is the first this is the container, and in this container water is there. Now the temperature of this water is 20 the temperature of this water is 100 degrees Celsius, right? Now state function, it means that they do not depend upon the path or the route by which that state has attained. They only depend upon the initial state and the final state. Student, consider that if someone asks you to go to the fifth floor, right? So fifth floor, when you are standing, so the potential energy which you have, the potential energy will remain the constant when you are standing there on the fifth floor. So there that potential energy do not depend upon the path which you have taken, like whether you have reached to the fifth floor by lift or by staircase, but work done by your legs depends upon the path section. So work which we are doing depend upon the path which we have taken, and that is known as path function, not the state function. So when here I am taking an example of water, so 100 degree Celsius was the final state of that reaction. So it does not depend upon whether you have decreased the temperature from 200 degree Celsius or whether you have increased the temperature from 50 degree Celsius. It does not depend upon the route which you have taken to achieve that state. It only depends upon the initial and the final state, right? So student, see, this is known as state function, like pressure, temperature, these all of them are the state function. So only the thing which we need to keep in mind is that state functions are those state variables. State functions are those state variables which do not depend upon the path which has the path or route which you have taken to do that. It only depends upon the initial and the final reaction. Okay, student, if you will take in day-to-day life, one more example relevant to state function is, consider that this is a person A. This is person A, and he has to reach here to the point B. He has to reach here to the point B. So this is the initial state and this one is the final state. Okay, so whatever the path it has been taken, consider that may this student has taken the path in this way, or may this has taken the path in this way. So these are the two paths, path 1 and path 2. So state function do not depend upon the path taken by that student to reach to its destination. Only the initial state and final state only depend upon the initial and the final state, and such type of functions are known as state functions. To student, I hope you understood the concept of state variable, state function and the state of the system. Now let's understand the next one, and that one is macroscopic system and properties. Macroscopic system and properties. So in macroscopic, according to its word, the observable or measurable properties can be considered as a macroscopic particles. So student, here in this macroscopic property, when you will study the macroscopic properties, we can say that here we have two type of properties. First one is extensive properties and second one is intensive properties. Okay, so let's understand extensive properties are those properties which depend upon the matter, depend upon the matter present in the container, whereas intensive properties are those properties which do not depend upon the matter. So student, this I will be explaining by taking another example. So student, let me give an example so you will understand extensive and intensive. So student, here I am having a container, and in this container, see, I am giving this example to you all. Okay, now this is the mass. If I say the volume of this container, so V is the volume of container. Here also V is the volume of container. Now consider that if I did two parts of it, if I did two parts of this container, so the volume will get, the volume will get halved. The volume will get halved, whereas if the temperature is T is the temperature, so volume will get halved and temperature remains the same. Here also volume will be halved and temperature remains the same of that container, whatever the matter is there inside. So in this way, student, we can say that volume is a extensive property. Volume is a extensive property, whereas temperature is the intensive property. So how can we explain? By taking an example of these two cubes. The cube are having volume V and temperature T. So after making it into half, volume get halved, right? The volume get halved and temperature remains the same. And in this way, we can explain the extensive and intensive property. And student, one more concept we should know, that is too extensive. When we are taking two extensive ratio of two extensive property, and those two extensive property can be intensive property. Intensive, how it can be possible? Let me give you the example. Extensive, so if I am taking about mass, mass is also extensive property because it depends upon the matter, how much matter is present in that container, upon volume. Mass upon volume, when you are taking the ratio of two extensive properties, so it is a density, and density is one of the intensive property. So student, I hope you understood all the concepts today which I taught, extensive and intensive. So do study, make your notes, and whatever doubts you have, you can ask me. Thank you, students, and have a good day ahead.